they love the people with the gender fairies. But I want to just kind of show you a little bit of him before the gender fairies had become out of the bottle. And just show you. So this is a guy called Philosophy Tube, and he is going to educate you and me, praise Jesus, about transphobia. Very excited. Very excited.
Before we dive into the remainder of this video, I should say up front that I am cisgender. Oh. For those of you who might be new to this sort of terminology, that means that my gender matches the one I was assigned at birth. So I'm not transgender. And this video is pitched at cis people who might be encountering these concepts for the very first time. And
this guy has a real problem with women.
He's going to become one any minute.
Well, like. He's calling us all kinds of nasty names here, very triggering.
The acronym Trans Exclusionary Radical Feminists, or TERFs, the academic feminist subset of transphobes. One transphobic academic
Fart whose sounds.
work you may encounter is Ray Blanchard, who's already been thoroughly debunked by sharper minds than mine. More recently, though, in 2014, philosopher Sheila Jeffries wrote a provocative and controversial book called Gender Hurts. Among other things, Jeffries falsely claims that the existence of trans people...
I wonder if Sheila Jeffries is going to print a retraction now that she will be seeing this. Oh, well, let's see. What does this bloke have to tell us about Sheila Jeffries? Gender Hurts, I wonder. Mm-hmm. I wonder. Mm-hmm. Probably the quintessential book, I would say, on probably since like the female eunuch and the continuation on of like the transsexual empire. But like Sheila Jeffries for that book went into the darkest corners of this whole, I mean, the whole lot. Mm-hmm. She went into it. The online activities of these subjects. Sheila Jeffries' book was anything but superficial. Okay. She may be a little bit transphobic, but let's see. I really want to
call
see
and tell her.
I want to see him mansplain to us. Sorry. Mansplain, is he a, no, he's still a man now. Let's
is
see him.
Is he cisplaining? Is that it? Is he cis?
He's cisplaining Sheila Jeffries. Go for
Jeffries
it.
Jeffries wrote a provocative and controversial book called Gender Hurts. Among other things, Jeffries falsely claims that the existence of trans people would erase lesbians and gay men. Since if a gay man could be attracted to somebody with a vagina or a lesbian could be attracted to somebody with a penis, then she says, wrongly, those categories must have broken down. Again, here we see the metaphysical denial at work. Transphobes today are sidelining metaphysics in order to focus on this question, how do you know? Which we can keep posing again and again forever, like a kid in the backseat of a car going, why, but why, but why, for eternity. Jeffries refuses the metaphysical truth that some women have penises and some men have vaginas.
A metaphysical truth?
Huh. Oh, I'm learning things. So, okay. So the metaphysical truth that some men have vaginas, some women have penises. Okay. Yep. So it's faith is what he's talking about. A faith kind of thing.
The way that he has to keep saying wrong.
Right.
It's like, this is the grooming. And I'm looking at his channel, Philosophy Tube, and I'm thinking, no, this is a guy who's got the stuff that he has about, again, we've talked about this a lot where this is a religion.
Yeah.
And now what I'm hearing spewing out of his mouth is not coming from the side of a philosophical side. It literally is sounding like he's coming across as somebody who studies religion.
Mm-hmm.
And that this is, there's the right and the wrong about mm-hmm. that. And he's saying that Sheila Jeffries, I mean, at this point, to bring it up and say, metaphysically, that these things he's saying are proper.
Man's a descent into madness. That's for sure.
Okay. Sidelining metaphysics in order to focus on this question, how do you know? Which we can keep posing again and again forever, like a kid in the backseat of a car going, why? But why? But why? For eternity. Jefferies refuses the metaphysical truth that some women have penises and some men have vaginas in order to focus on this question. How do you know that someone is a lesbian? Okay, how do you know that? How do you know that?
Joey, how do you know if someone's a lesbian? Maybe I'm getting it wrong. Maybe this guy is right. How do you know someone is lesbian?
His gaydar is better than mine, I guess. I don't know. As a cis man, who knows?
What
came to him biologically?
Hume raises an interesting question, though. What are transphobes trying to achieve with all of this hardline skepticism? Why, in the potluck of life, are they only bringing industrial amounts of the blandest possible coleslaw? Well, beyond just garden variety bigotry, one theoretical explanation might be that once we realize trans people exist, and therefore must be legally acknowledged to exist, we can start having more interesting conversations, like, what can we do about the fact that a lot of trans people don't have access to the healthcare they need? What can we do about the fact that a lot of trans people are disproportionately more likely to be refused jobs? Once we acknowledge that people exist, then we can have a conversation about material access to their human rights. But as long as the debate don't stop and the metaphysical skepticism is maintained, all those questions get delayed.
Okay, so what he's trying to say here is that the reason that we are continually talking about our sex-based rights is an attempt to subvert the real question, which should be, why do these people not have access to hormones and surgeries? This is what he's trying to say. And Sheila Jeffries, on it, you know, obviously is guilty of crimes against humanity. We're often told this by merely being skeptical or non-believers. I would call myself I'm actually a non-believer. I'm a gender atheist. By virtue of me being that, I am denying people healthcare. And I think that's one of the most disingenuous and disgusting ways to turn what we are saying around and against us. And this bloke is so bloody, he's so predictable. Remember, he has been playing a part for 30 something years as a cis man, and we're going to see it in all its glory now. Nobody else took his place and bravely cried,
I'm a black star, I'm a black star. Why am I not surprised? Okay.
I'm so glad I don't have to do the voice anymore. Okay. Hello. My name is Abigail Thorne. I'm the creator of Philosophy Tube. I do a lot of characters and visual metaphor and stuff on the show, so for the final part of today's episode, I wanted to drop the act. And for once...
Finish up the act!
Wait, what's the book? Do you know what that book is we've got there? Is it significant at all?
Oh my gosh. Is it? I think... it could be Whipping Girl.
That's what I'm thinking. It looks familiar.
the gender genie is out of the bottle. Praise the gender gods. We have another one.
Full blown.
I'm a gender in a bottle.
A trans coming out, sir. It should be retitled Full-Blown AGP Now Coming Out.
Oh my god, these guys are so predictable.
Just to explain to you what's going on. So, first of all, this is not a joke.
No, it is. It is
not a performance. It's not part of the
on a comedy panel.
This is real.
Yeah, it
I'm
really
transgender. If you've seen any Philosophy Tube before, you might have known me by a different name. But off camera, all my friends and family call me Abigail, or Abby, or Abs. And everything I own is under that name. All my ID says Miss Abigail Thorne and female.
You have no abs, I'll tell you that.
She went to the shops to pick up her groceries. I've been deliberate. I change my clothes and I change my body language, and I've been wearing big jackets to hide my breasts.
And I talk like this!
But actually, this is the real me. This is my coming out video. It's this job. It's really killing me. I pretend like it's all right when I'm there, but I just...
Being a woman or being a man, it's just a job.
And I don't know if I can get a job doing anything else. I don't know if I'm qualified, if anyone else is even hiring, so I don't know what I'm gonna do. But I know that a lot of other people would kill to have this job, and I know I wish I could just get on with it, but I can't, because it's not the right job for me. Well, that's what it was like for me, having to live as boy.
Imagine the facile mindset of thinking that woman or man is a job that you just need to, just give it up. I wasn't having a good time as a man, so I just gave it up. Just gave it up without any, you know, and that's all there is to it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. How misogynistic.
And again, this fragility, this thing about...
Are you listening to the little voice he's doing? This little voice. My breasts. I'm so precious and so fragile. And all of my... it's like disgusting. It's whenever these people come out as women, they always go immediately into this like damsel in distress mode. Like, look at me, I couldn't possibly open the door. I'm just a woman.
Oh. And the outfit, the outfit to come out, if this is his big coming out thing, you know, he's done it with such a conservative look. He didn't pick the whole pornified thing. Mm-hmm. But this is what I see. It goes from this really pornified thing or little girl. Mm-hmm. We've seen that. This is where this is sort of bordering on. But this is more like conservative.
Yeah.
Right.
It's like a twin set. A lot of the men, they do this kind of twin set look. You know, they wear the cardigan and the shirt and a little bit like they dress a bit like their mums.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, this guy makes me sick.
Well, let's see where he's going to take us. You know,
I did hear something. I think I caught something because you have taught me about AGPs and you said they're all straight.
Yeah.
And I know gay men that would dress like this at home or be with their lovers like this. And even some that dared to go out, this is years ago, dared to go out in public like this, mm-hmm, as the housewife that was shopping or whatever. And they were gay as shit, but not. Again, what do you say when a man who is gay, who's really trying to pass that way, but knows he's a man and would never go around?
Are you talking about cross-dressing or what do you mean? Like,
all of it used to be transvestites. I mean, you know, we used to just say that.
Transvestites were typically straight. So are you meaning like female impersonators?
I'm talking about gay men that definitely cross-dress that are transvestites in, mm-hmm, my language.
Mm-hmm.
And he... And most of these people that we're seeing, these men that we're seeing that are violent, that are heterosexual, they want to get into these, you know, they're vile predators.
Mm-hmm.
This guy just was, I don't know if he's just talking to the audience, he's acting another part, whatever. And he said something about a partner you might say to him is what, mm-hmm, he said. And I, mm-hmm, now I'm curious about, do you think this guy could be gay?
No. So he's as straight as they come. But right, what many of these guys do develop, and this is discovered a lot by Bailey and by Blanchard and also by Anne Lawrence, who is an AGP researcher. I mean, he was AGP himself. And he wrote, mm-hmm, a book, Men Trapped in Men's Bodies. He said that a lot of these autogynephiles, they would develop something called pseudo-bisexuality. So their love for their attraction or their desire to be with a man is driven by the desire to be treated as a woman by whilst they are being loved by a man. So
they have very stereotyped ideas about sex between men and women, and that's it, the role playing and the whatever.
So if he, for example, was to have like a romantic encounter with a man, it would be stimulating for him to be treated as a lady by a man, but these guys are on the foundations very, very heterosexual, and the type of change in their sexuality is or if there is a change in their sexuality, it's what Blanchard and Bailey defined as being pseudo-bisexual.
Pseudo-bisexual, thank you. Interesting.
And part of the ETLE, which is the erotic target location error.
Your mental health starts to improve. The people who love you say, wow, you really seem like you're in a much better place. I'm really happy for you. Your relationships start clicking again. And then one day...
And by the way, just so you know, this is not the way things go. Generally speaking, when AGPs come out of the closet, their entire lives break down. We see it time and time again with their personal relationships, with their marriages. There might be like a small period of like, you know, like a kind of a sugar high, like a little euphoria. But then when real life settles in, their lives really are in disarray. That's why so many of them get divorced.
And their children don't want to talk to them, and their children don't even want to be seen by them if they cross them on the sidewalk in the street.
Because I don't believe that somebody like India Willoughby's son is a raging transphobe. I just think he sees his father for the narcissist that he is and has said no more.
I never thought
he's crying.
I never thought that I could be so simply happy. It's amazing. The old job was hard, but this, it's like I was made for it, which of course I was, because despite being legally blind, I could still see all the colors. And that's pretty much it. But actually, my primary experience of my body now is relaxation and comfort. I don't want to give you the big monologue that you might have been expecting about how ashamed and disgusted I am with myself, because...
Because you're turned on by yourself. This is it. That's the shame, really, is that he's this is a bit, look at the whole thing. This is a whole big turn on for you. Well done.
And and now we know that he used that book of Audre Lorde, who's a lesbian. She's it makes me want to throw that book in his face. But isn't this a signaling that I am so hip that I know about feminism? I know about a lesbian feminist who is really strong about women and would approve of my...
Oh, approve, 100% approve.
Total approval.
And Sheila Jeffries, I just got to talk that bitch round. Wait till she sees me, Sheila Jeffries.
I'm actually a little bit proud of being trans. I've done something that's difficult and it's a little bit different.
It's not different. Everybody's trans nowadays. You've done something trendy.
To be happy, and it doesn't hurt anyone else. So
it does hurt other people. It hurts women. It hurts women very, very much, because now you're going to be using our spaces and using our language and potentially using our prisons and basically making a mockery out of our entire sex class. So yes, it does hurt someone, but continue on, you narcissist.
Cool. I've read enough feminist philosophy to know that being female is no less worthy than being male. And I've read...
I'm sorry. I must have had a stroke there, Joey. Can you explain to me what he just said? He's read enough. I can't. My brain just won't compute the words that he's saying.
He is so intelligent.
But wait, but did you hear what he just said? That he has read enough. Okay, but you are male. So how does that make sense? It's nice that you've read the feminist philosophy and that you understand that being female is no less than being male, but how does it help you? You're male.
Unless he's so threatened. That's it. That's how it's helped him to realize he's so threatened by it. He's read enough to know he's threatened by it. And that's why he's now going to explain to us, to educate us. Isn't that what he's doing?
No, I think he's making a claim that, because it's this thing about using female, right? I can play along with this idea, I identify as a woman, but when he actually starts saying female, I'm like, wait, are you fully on that train? Because you are male, and he has enjoyed his position in the world because he is male. He has his job, he has his YouTube channel because he is male. So to turn it around at this stage and said, I did it all despite being female,
disingenuous to say.
Hey, if you're just here to have some fun and learn some philosophy, that's why I'm a woman now. I've got some great episodes planned for this year. Patreon.com/philosophytube is where you can sign up to help me make the show.
No, I will not. And he is just he actually has copied words, not word for word, but his trajectory has been done before by another guy who we're also going to get into.